lives one day at a time. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. They're here to get your day going fine. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio.
And here's your host, Miss Kim Robinson.
This thing called life. We live, we live, we live, we live. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou for me.
Hey, I've seen a lot of things in my lifetime, and had a bunch of crushed dreams in my lifetime, and did some messed up things in my lifetime, in my lifetime, in my lifetime. Said I've seen a bunch of things in my lifetime, and had a bunch of crushed dreams in my lifetime, and did some messed up things in my lifetime, in my lifetime, in my lifetime.
Comfort
me.
Well, hello, hello, hello. I am not the one to gossip, but y'all know what time it is. From Under a Bridge Radio Talk Show, I am your host, Blossom. I want to tell you thank you for stopping by. When I tell you God is so good, no matter what we're going through, y'all, we got to keep on pressing because the blessing is in the pressing. Like I said, I'm just happy, baby. I'm just really, really happy. All is well. We just have to know that God is who he is. I like to give a little shout out to my little Kimmy Kim, sending prayers and love to all the rest of the radio hosts for allowing me to be part of this family. And just to the listeners for stopping by today, and because you could have been doing anything else, but you stopped by to listen to From Under a Bridge Radio Talk Show. We have a great speaker tonight. I've heard her story. And when I tell you God can do anything, there's nothing too hard for God. I don't like to tell people testimony because they can tell it better than I can. But before I bring her on, I want us all to go into prayer and give credit where credit is due, because if it wasn't for God that was on our side, where would we be? So if you'll join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for another blessed day. Thank you for being the God that you are, a true, merciful, kind, loving, understanding, all-knowing, all-seeing. Lord, if we had 1,000 tongues, we couldn't thank you enough. Lord, we ask you to forgive us for our sins and unspoken sins. We ask you to bless our families, our friends, and our enemies. Now, Lord, I ask that we may decrease so that you can increase, and I show today a blessed someone. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Like I said, my name is Blossom. This is From Under a Bridge Radio Talk Show. This woman of God, I've heard her story. Mighty woman of God. She's small, but she has a powerful story. And I don't want to take nothing away from her. As y'all know, I like my guests to introduce themselves because, like I said, they can do it better than I can. And some of them have their names be so pretty and odd, I just don't want to mess their names up. So I always turn the mic back over to God and to my guest. Is my guest there today?
Yes.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm great. Praise the Lord. How are you?
I'm doing fine. If you, for the next 30 to 35 minutes, if you could introduce yourself and tell the people, because I've already heard your story, but if you could tell them what God has done in your life.
Hi, this is Minister Tisha Whitfield, coming from Tuscaloosa, Alabama. And I just thank God for the opportunity to be on Blossom Radio today. And I just thank God for his goodness. I thank God for his grace. I just thank God for everything that he has done in my life. And I tell you, I don't look like what I have been through, but I can tell you that there is a God, and I just thank God for what he brought me through. I thank God for how he have kept me and protected me in the midst of what I went through, because even as a child, I was going through abuse. I was being abused by my mother, and I didn't have no one that I could depend on. I thought that God had forsaken me. I thought that he didn't love me. You know, and I was too busy, you know, searching for love because I didn't have God's love to carry me through it because I lived in fear. I was so depressed. I even thought of committing suicide because of how bad the abuse was inside the home. And I was saying to myself, you know, even going through that God, why would you allow me to be abused? Why would you allow me to go through this? And I didn't feel like God had loved me. I thought God hated me. I thought that I was going to hell because I was going through that, and I didn't know anyone else that was going through it. And even people surrounded in my life that I told, they didn't believe me because me being a black woman, they did not expect that to happen in a black family. And so it was so hard, you know, growing up. And I remember, you know, I used to, you know, pray and hope that one day I would get to leave from that home. And God, he intervened for me. He made a way for me to leave that home in 2009. And I end up listening to the enemy and causing me to go back to that home. And so God intervened again, and he told me, you know, that he's going to deliver me this time, but this time do not return back. Because when I returned the second time, the abuse was worse the second time than the first time. And the second time when I returned, that's the same year I got saved, baptized with water, filled with the Holy Ghost. And that was the same year God revealed to me his calling for my life, that he had called me to minister all across the world, you know, to people, to the lost, people that was broken, people that was going through abuse, not just physically but even emotionally, you know, people that feel lost in this world. And I thank God for that because, you know, I was still searching for myself even when I got saved. And I remember I was meeting different people inside church and, you know, trying to find church family that I could bond with that, you know, could help my walk with God. And I still didn't know how to lean on God's strength on my own. And so in the midst of it, you know, I was getting hurt by people inside the church. And I was like, well, Lord, these people are supposed to be your children. So, Lord, why are you allowing this to happen? But I had to learn to put my trust in God and knowing that he is the only one that could get me through what I was facing, the trials, the tribulations that I was going through. You know, I have lived from house to house, staying with people, because keep in mind, I got out of the situation of being abused, and God opened a door for me to escape. And so, you know, I was staying with people, and then I ended up going to my dad's house, and I was down there, and I was staying down there. And I didn't even seek the Lord about staying down there. And because I didn't seek the Lord, things started manifesting that I didn't even believe would even happen, you know, in my life. And the devil was using them, had them call the police on me, telling the police that I was mentally ill and that I was going to harm myself and other people. And I was so offended because I was like, why am my family, you know, doing this to me? And I couldn't understand it. I couldn't comprehend it. I was too busy looking at the outer appearance, and I couldn't really see that it was the devil behind all this. And so, you know, I had to go to God and ask the Lord to help me to forgive them, you know, in the midst of that. And so, you know, my dad and his parents, my grandparents, you know, they kicked me out of the house, and so I became homeless. I was homeless for almost 2 years, and I was sleeping outside. There was nights that I was outside in the cold. There was nights I was outside in the heat, and even nights when it was raining and I was outside. And experiencing that, I never believed that I would personally go through that. And, you know, I dealt with all kinds of people. You know, I had people come to me, they was accusing me of being on drugs or being an alcoholic. And I was not on drugs while I was out there, and I was not even drinking alcohol while I was out there. You know, people was accusing me of being a prostitute, and I wasn't a prostitute. My mind was steadily on God. I was daily seeking him, asking the Lord, please remove me from being homeless because I don't like this lifestyle. And I know that you have better for me. And, you know, I cried so much. I was always crying. And, you know, I'm like, Lord, could you please remove me from this situation? Because, you know, these people that I come across, they don't understand my relationship with God. You know, a lot of people, you know, was mistaking me for other people that was homeless, you know, and that was frustration with me emotionally because my identity, people didn't even know my identity. But I was mistaking my identity for someone else's, and people was laughing at me because I was outside with my stuff, you know. And it wasn't just strangers, you know. It was people in church, people outside of church, people I knew, people that I didn't know. You know, you had, it was one time that this mother, she looked at me with fear because she had believed that I was going to harm her and her children. And so I was, and it just so happened, I was reading my Bible when this happened, and I was highlighting my Bible, and I looked up, and that's when I saw how she was looking at me with fear, because the devil was making her believe that. And I have never harmed anyone, and I did not have that mentality of that, but going through that, you know, and I was like, well, Lord, if she only knew that I was yours, if she only knew that I was your child, if she only knew what I was going through, you know, and that's how it was with a lot of people. They was like, well, why are you homeless? You know, are you mentally ill? Are you a veteran? You know, everybody wanted to know why. And a lot of times when I would tell them, hey, you know, I was living with my family members and they kicked me out, but I go way back there. I came from an abusive home, and a lot of people, they cannot understand that. It was people that was telling me to go back to abusive home because they just did not want me to be out there. And I was telling them that me being outside homeless, no, I did not desire that lifestyle. I didn't want it at all, but I was safer being out there than being at my family's house where I was getting abused, because I didn't have to worry about nobody harming me while I was out there. I didn't have to worry about anyone stealing from me while I was out there. The Lord, he kept me. I didn't go without anything to eat unless I was fasting. When I say I saw the Lord move on my behalf, the Lord, he didn't not only send people to me to bless me, to bless me with something to eat, to give me a hotel for so many nights. And some people, he had them to take me to their home, invite me to their home. And it took a lot of faith for a lot of people to do that, because a lot of them did not even know me. And so they had to trust God and believe God that I was not going to try to harm them. And even, you know, me talking to them about the Lord, they still, you know, was kind of hesitant. But eventually, you know, they, you know, believed what God told them. And they took me to their house, and while I was there, God was using me to minister to them. And they really, you know, was growing in God while I was at their house. I was seeing deliverance take place. I have seen how when I was homeless, how this woman, she was going through stuff in her life, and how God had me speak a word to her, and it came to pass. I have seen how people have got healed. They had sicknesses, and God had them to come to me and ask for prayer. And I just saw how God did all that. And it wasn't about me. It was about God, about how he wanted to show himself to these people, that just because someone is homeless, that doesn't mean they don't have a relationship with God. That doesn't mean that they're not seeking his face always. That doesn't mean that they're not in the will of God, that they're not walking with him. And I was daily walking with him, daily seeking him. The Lord even sent his angels, not humans, but his angels himself to me. And I remember one particular time he did it. I didn't even know, because I was so frustrated. I was so tired. I was so offended because of the people that was coming to me that was having attitudes with me in the flesh. And I was like, Lord, give me self-control. Lord, you know, because I'm your child, and I don't want to appear to not be your light in the midst of what's going on. And, you know, I saw how God, he took that, and he made something greater out of it, how he, you know, he brought a blessing out of it. And when I say he had brought one of his angels, and his angels had brought me a large meat lover's pizza. It was hot, a hot pizza and a bottle of water. And he asked me what my name is, and I told him my name is Tisha. And so he gave it to me, and he said, I'm going to get you a hotel for tonight. And he said, it'll be in 30 minutes. I said, okay. And so in 30 minutes, this woman pulls up, and she asked me, was I okay? I said, yeah, I'm okay. I'm waiting on this man. He's a manager from Domino's, because that's what he told me, that he was a manager from Domino's. And so I said, I'm waiting on him to come back through. And so she said, well, I'm going to go ahead and get you a hotel for tonight. And when you get in there, you call Domino's and you tell the manager that you got a hotel for tonight and he can pay for tomorrow's night. And so I get in the room and I call Domino's and I say, hey, can you tell the manager at Domino's that I got a hotel for tonight and he can pay for tomorrow's night? And I was describing the man to them and telling them what kind of car he had and everything. And they said, there is no one that looks like that that works here. There's no one that drives that kind of car here. And in that moment, the Lord brought the word of God to me that when he talks about that for us to be careful that we entertain angels unaware. And I was like, Lord, I didn't even know that you have put an angel before me, literally. And I was like, Lord, if I knew, I would have been asking so many questions, you know. But I thank God that, you know, he didn't have to provide for me. He didn't have to protect me. He didn't have to feed me. He didn't have to do any of those things for me, but yet he did it. You know, I had men coming to me and trying to get me to prostitute, and the Lord boldness would rise up inside of me and to rebuke those devils coming to me. And, you know, people will come just to hear the word of God. You know, it was so many people that was lost, different backgrounds, different religions, and they was thirsty for God, and they wanted Jesus in their life. But I had so many people that was telling me how they was going to their church, and they couldn't get Jesus like they needed because no one was willing to work with them. But yet, here I am outside homeless with my stuff, and yet God is working it out for my good, even though I did not listen to him and seek him about going to my family house. But he still used what meant to harm me and worked it out for my good. And, you know, a lot of times I have been ashamed to even share my testimony of being homeless and even being abused by my mother, because a lot of people, they won't receive it, because I have experienced, you know, both sides of it. A lot of people had thought I was making it up. You know, some people was thinking I'm telling them because I was looking for a handout. And, you know, the Lord was telling me, you know, I need to share my testimony, because when we share our testimony, it brings deliverance and healing in people's lives. And, you know, I just thank God because, you know, I thank God that I'm not homeless anymore. I thank God how last year, in February of last year, how the Lord delivered me from that lifestyle. And I thank God because if it wasn't for his grace, if it wasn't for his mercy, I would not even be here today. You know, if it wasn't for his grace and his mercy, the things that I faced would have went the other way. And that's why I continue to seek the Lord, because all I ever wanted was a relationship with him. All I ever wanted was his love. And that's why I thank God that when he found me, it was back in 2011 when he did, I thank God that he saved me and he delivered me, you know, from all those things. I thank God for how he even interceded on my behalf, you know, to deliver me out of all my troubles. And, you know, I thank God how last summer, the Lord favored interceded where I was able to go back to college and get a degree. And I never thought that I would ever be going back to college. I never thought that I would be pursuing a degree. And I was talking to the Lord, asking the Lord, what do you want me to go to college for? And he put in my spirit to go to college for a wellness fitness instructor. So that's the program I'm in now, and God has been using that program to not just cleanse, you know, us physically, you know, from stuff that we eat and drink that harm us, but even spiritually, you know, spiritual cleanse that I have seen God been doing is me, but not just me, but people I come in contact with even at school. And I thank God because this is my junior year, praise the Lord, and in the spring I'll be graduating, Lord's will, thank the Lord for that, you know, because I did not know that I would be in a place that God has me at now. But I always believed for God to move on my behalf, but I never knew what he would do on my behalf. And that's why I tell anyone that whatever they're facing, to not give up on God, because he has not given up on you. And as long as you're in his will, you will see things come to pass in your life.
Amen, amen.
Well, I tell you, I told y'all she had a powerful story. I want to thank you so, so much. Do we have any guests that would like to make a comment or ask a question? Well, I guess you answered everything, Tisha. I want to thank you so much for coming on and sharing your story, and just continue to keep letting God use you, mighty woman of God. Like I said, God is just good. I'm just sitting over here because so much of that reminds me of my story, being homeless. And we are overcomers by our testimony. So, we, like I said, we just want to ask you to keep pressing and keep telling your story, and no weapon formed against you shall prosper. With that being said, I always like to open up the doors of the church because there's nothing like being saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. So if you like to give your life to Christ, and it's not a religion, it's a relationship, because in the midnight hours you can call and talk to him. You don't have to worry about if the line is busy or does he have time for you. I repent of my sins. I'm asking Jesus to come into my heart, to be my Lord and my Savior. And just that, saying just that, you're born again. So don't let nobody tell you that God doesn't love you, because he loves you. He sent Jesus to die on the cross for us. But like I said, I am not the one to gossip, but you have joined us tonight here on From Under a Bridge Radio Talk Show. I am your host, Blossom, and please join us next Sunday. We'll have another powerful testimony. Have a blessed day.
It's hard, and you know I got faith. I'm not ungrateful, thanks for mercy and grace. But every day, problems steady in my face, and the enemy is steady on my case. I walk around in the public, I'm okay, but my soul is in such a dark place. I ride around, I'm just one step away. Me back to the streets is what they want to see. Pastor Gardner ministers to me. Who thought 3 a.m. be the first time we speak? In the word, gotta get my roots deep. I be eating scripture to the point I'm obese. Easy to turn to the streets, I was a beast. But there's a part of me that still wanna eat. See, my spirit and my flesh wanna agree. And every day I live, life steady getting at me.
I got everyday life steady coming at me. Everyday problems steady trying to grab me. So I'ma give them up to you.
Give them up, hey.
I'ma throw them up to you.
I'ma throw them up.
I can't run.
Coming, but the money ain't matching. The ends used to meet when I was out there trapping. Kids gotta eat and they want the new fashion. I'm trying to do my best, but their mamas just keep snapping. Life's a test and I plan on passing. We all know at times it gets drastic, and you can be aware of your happiness. We all fall short, that's just part of the story. I'm on my knees daily praying, not asking for a miracle, but God, I'm just saying. And my faith stands tall, but them naysayers waiting for my fall. But they're watching from afar. They don't know that where I am, there you are. And yes, I know all of this, but it don't stop the everyday struggles for Chris.
I got everyday life steady coming at me. Everyday problems steady trying to grab me. So I'ma give them up to you.
Give them up, hey.
I'ma
throw them up.
I can't run,
run, run.
Problems, I'ma run,
run, run,
run. When I can solve them, man, I'ma give them up to you.
Give them up, hey.
I'ma throw them up to you.
What I'm gonna do next time, thoughts in my mind about me heading back to grind. When these bills I gotta sort through, money getting short too. Here's what I'm gonna do.
I'ma throw them up to you.
I'ma throw them up, yeah.
I'ma give them up to you.
I'ma give them up to you. Hey, ain't no more worrying about it. Hey, God, it's all in your hands now. Whoa.
I'ma give them up to you.
Give them up, hey.